We have been hearing the amazing story that the Wordless book has to tell us. Can you remember what color the first page of the Wordless book is? That's right, it's the gold page, and the gold page reminds us of God. Can you remember what color the next page of the Wordless book is? That's right, it's the dark page, and the dark page reminded us of sin. What color was the next page of the Wordless book? That's right, it was the red page, and the red page reminds us of the Lord Jesus Christ, how he died on the cross and how he rose again from the dead. The next page of our Wordless book is actually this page. It's the clean page, and this page reminds me of the life that God wants us to have. God wants you to have a life that is pure, that is perfect, that is sinless. He wants you to have a life that is like the Lord Jesus Christ. You might think to yourself, that's impossible. That's impossible because of sin. But it is possible. And this is the life that God wants you to have before you can go and live with Him forever and ever in heaven. It is possible. It is possible because of God's wonderful plan, His wonderful plan to send the Lord Jesus Christ to be the Saviour of the world. It is possible because of what the Lord Jesus Christ did when He died on the cross. But now Jesus is alive. He had risen from the dead 3 days later, and some women who had come to the tomb, they now knew that Jesus was alive, and Peter and John knew that Jesus was alive, but only a few people really knew that Jesus was alive. These two men in the picture, they're walking to Emmaus. They had been in Jerusalem. They had been followers of Jesus. Perhaps they had even seen Jesus being crucified. They maybe had seen him dying on that cross. And they were sad and they were confused. And the Bible says that as they walked along this long, dusty road that was 7 miles long or 10 kilometers long, they were talking about everything that had happened in Jerusalem. You know, they felt sad. They'd heard that some women had said that Jesus is alive, but they didn't really believe it. Maybe these women had just imagined that they'd seen that angel. Maybe they just imagined that Jesus was alive. Could it possibly be true? They didn't think so. They didn't believe it. And as they were walking along this road, the Bible tells us that this stranger appeared beside them. And this stranger could see that they were sad and confused. And the stranger said, "What are you talking about?" One of these two men was called Cleopas. And he spoke and he said, "Have you not heard? Where have you been? Do you not know what has happened in Jerusalem the past 3 days?" And these two men went on to explain how Jesus had died on the cross and how he was now dead. And they thought that Jesus was going to be the Messiah, the promised one sent from God. They thought that Jesus would rescue them from their enemies, those Romans that ruled over them. But now it seemed that all hope was gone. He was dead. And now some of Jesus' followers say that Jesus is alive, but they didn't believe it. You know, as the stranger heard these words, he spoke these words to them, and he said, "Why are you so foolish? Why are you so slow to believe?" It says here in the Bible in Luke chapter 24, "Do you not remember that the prophet said that the promised one would die, that he would suffer all of these things before he would go back to heaven?" And this stranger went on to explain to them and talk to them about what the prophets had said in the Old Testament. How they said that Jesus would suffer, that he would die, that he would be punished for the sins of everyone in the whole world. And maybe these two men felt a bit better. They maybe felt better after talking to this stranger. But they still didn't believe that Jesus was alive. They didn't believe it. I wonder, do you believe what God says? Do you believe what God says about sin, about the seriousness of sin, about how sin will be punished? Do you believe that Jesus was punished for all of your sin when he died on the cross? Do you believe that Jesus is alive? God wants you to believe his words. He wants you to believe that it's true. And it is true. These two men continued to be sad and confused. And when they got to Emmaus, they invited the stranger to come and to have a meal with them. This stranger accepted their invitation. And when they were in the home, as this stranger was giving thanks for the bread, as he broke the bread, these two men realized who he was. Do you know who this stranger is? That's right, it's Jesus. And these two men were amazed and they were so excited. It is him. It is Jesus. He is alive. They believed that Jesus is alive because they could see him with their very own eyes. They knew that it was true. Jesus really is alive. He truly is the Son of God. He truly is the Savior. Believing that Jesus is alive makes all the difference. It changes everything. Knowing that Jesus is alive can change your life. It proves to us that he really is the Son of God, that he is all powerful, and that nothing is impossible with him. If I go into Tesco's and I buy all of my groceries, I get a receipt at the end, and this receipt proves that I have bought all of my groceries that are in my trolley, and I can now take them home. The fact that Jesus is alive is like a receipt. It's proof. What does it prove? It proves that Jesus has paid for the punishment of your sin. And the fact that he's alive shows that Jesus has paid the punishment for your sin, for my sin, and for the sins of everyone in the whole world. See, if Jesus was still dead, you might think to yourself, I wonder, did Jesus really pay for my sin? Was he really punished for all of my sin? How would I know? He's still dead. But the fact that he's alive proves that he has been punished for your sin. And it makes all the difference. It can change your life. These two men were so excited. And it says that Jesus vanished and he was gone. And these two men didn't just think to themselves, we'll go to bed, we'll get up early in the morning, and then we'll go to Jerusalem. No, they were so excited. The Bible says that they immediately left their home and they ran the whole way back to Jerusalem. Where were they going? They were going to tell the disciples that they'd seen Jesus, that he is alive. And when they got to Jerusalem, they found the disciples were in a room. The doors were all locked because the disciples were afraid. They were afraid in case they too would get arrested, in case they too would be put to death, just the same way that Jesus had. But these two men were so excited and they probably banged on the door and they were like, let us in, let us in. We've seen him. We've seen Jesus. And maybe they told the disciples everything that had happened to them, how they'd walked with him, how they'd talked with him, the whole way to Emmaus, and how when he broke the bread and gave thanks, they knew who it was. It was Jesus. He's alive. And as these two men were talking to the disciples about everything that had happened to them, the Bible tells us in Luke chapter 24 that Jesus appeared in the room. He appeared to them. The disciples were amazed. Is it really Jesus? They were terrified. It looked like him, but could it really be him? Maybe it was a ghost. And then Jesus spoke these words, and he said this. He said, peace to you. And he said, why are you troubled? And why do doubts arise in your hearts? See my hands and my feet, that it is I myself. Touch me and see. For a spirit does not have flesh and bones, as you see that I have. And then he showed them his hands, and he showed them his feet. And while they looked at him in amazement, he said, have you anything here to eat? And they gave him some fish. It really was Jesus. He was there. He was there in his real body. They could see the nail prints in his hands. He truly is alive. He truly is the Savior of the world. And these disciples believed that Jesus is alive. He wanted them to understand what he had done for them because he loved them. And Jesus loves you too, and he wants you to understand what he has done for you. When he died on the cross, he was punished for your sin. He was punished for my sin. He was punished for the sins of everyone in the whole world. And Jesus rose again from the dead and he is alive today. He is the Savior of the world. And because he is alive, he can do an amazing thing for you. He can change your life. He can change your life today. Isn't that amazing? Isn't that wonderful news? And you might think to yourself, well, how can Jesus change my life? I wonder, have you ever done a swap at school? Maybe you collect football cards or stickers and you swap them with people to get the stickers or the football cards that you want. Well, Jesus wants to do a swap in your life. He wants to take the darkness of sin out of your life, and he wants to give you a life that is clean, that is pure, that is perfect. He wants to give you a life that is like his. And you might say to yourself, but that isn't possible. How could that really be possible? It's possible because of what Jesus did. And if you give him your sin and you tell him that you're sorry for all the wrong things that you have done, and if you believe that Jesus is alive, that he has paid for the punishment for your sins, then he will swap the darkness of sin out of your life and he will give you a life like this. And when God looks at your life, he will see your life like this. He will see the life of the Lord Jesus Christ. Could God allow you into heaven with a life like this? Yes, of course he could. And the amazing thing is that it can happen today. Your life can be changed today. That is the most amazing news ever. And it's all because Jesus is alive. You know, these disciples must have been absolutely amazed. They were never, ever going to forget this day. How could they forget this day? The day that they seen Jesus alive with their own eyes? And the Bible tells us that Thomas wasn't there when Jesus appeared to the disciples. But when Jesus disappeared, and when Thomas came into the room later on, the disciples told him everything that they had seen. You know, Thomas didn't believe it. He said, I won't believe it. I won't believe it until I see the nail prints in his hands, until I can touch the wound that is in his side. I refuse to believe. And he didn't believe. Maybe you're a bit like Thomas. Maybe you say, I don't believe it. But you know, Jesus wanted Thomas to believe. The Bible tells us that 8 days passed, and again Jesus appeared in the room. The doors were locked. Jesus appeared. It was a miracle. And Thomas was in the room. And the Bible says that Jesus spoke and he said, peace to you. And he spoke these words to Thomas and he said, look at me, touch my hands and my side, stop doubting, just believe. You know, when Thomas looked at Jesus, when he could see the wounds in his hands, when he could see the wound in his side, Thomas believed. What did he believe? He believed that Jesus is alive. He believed that Jesus is the savior of the world. He believed in Jesus. And the Bible says that Thomas looked at Jesus and he said this. He said, my Lord and my God. And Jesus spoke these words and he said, Thomas, because you have seen me, you believe. Blessed are those who have not seen me yet believe. Will you believe in the Lord Jesus Christ today? Will you believe that he can change your life? You know, over the next few days, Jesus appeared to many, many people. In fact, he appeared to over 500 people all at the one time. Many, many people seen Jesus and they knew that he was alive. But 40 days after Jesus had rose again from the dead, he went up into heaven in the clouds. And that's where Jesus is now. Jesus is alive today and he is in heaven and he is still the savior of the world and he can change your life today. You know, the lives of the disciples were changed. They were never the same again. The Bible tells us that they went out into the streets and they began to preach and they told people this good news that Jesus had died on the cross, had been punished for their sins, and that now Jesus is alive. And that they too could have their lives changed if they believed in him. And many people did believe in Jesus. Many people today believe in Jesus and they follow him and their lives are changed. Your life can be changed too if you believe in him. And there's a verse in the Bible in Acts chapter 13, verse 39, and it says this. You listen to it as I read it to you from the Bible. It says, everyone who believes is justified. You know, if you believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, if you trust in him to be your savior, that means turning away from sin, giving him your sin and telling him that you're sorry for it, then he will change your life. And this verse tells us in Acts 13, verse 39, that you will be justified. What does it mean to be justified? Being justified means that God will look at you He will look at your life as if you've never ever sinned. And when you're justified, God will look at your life and he will see the life of the Lord Jesus Christ. You will be justified forever. And someday you will go to live with God forever in heaven. I wonder, will you believe in the Lord Jesus today? You can do that just right where you sit. You can believe in him and your life will be changed. Your life can be changed because Jesus is alive.